welcome back to the Jab. Hello everyone, welcome back to Jab Jio Academy YouTube channel. So today our topic is, this is geochemistry lecture 4, and today our topic of discussion is half life.
Okay,
so half life is, it is a time after which the concentration of radionuclei becomes half of its original concentration. So it is the time, it is basically the time means the after which the radionuclei, the concentration of radionuclei becomes half of its original concentration. If the original concentration is 1, then after 1 half life, after 1 t half, it will reduce to how much? 1 by 2, and after another half life it will reduce to 1 by 4, and after another 1 half life it will reduce to 1 by 8, and like this 1 by 16. Okay, in the next half life 1 by 32, and like this it will go on. Okay, now second important point is that after 1 half life the concentration of parent nuclei and daughter nuclei will be same. Okay, so after 1 half life, if the parent is 1 by 2, okay, then the daughter will also be 1 by 2, both will be same. Okay, now we know that from previous lecture I have derived this equation P naught is equal to P to the power lambda T. Now after 1 half life P will be P naught divided by 2, P naught over 2, because after 1 half life it will reduce to 1 by 2, so P will be equal to, P means concentration of radionuclei after 1 half life, it will reduce to P naught by 2. P naught is equal to P e to the power lambda t. We have previously derived. Now put P in place of P is equal to P naught by 2. Now P naught by 2. Now okay, P naught is equal to P naught by 2 e to the power lambda t half. Okay, in place of t we have to write t half because we are calculating half life. So P naught cancel. Now half e to the power lambda t is equal to 1. Now e to the power lambda t half is equal to 2. Lambda t half is equal to ln 2. Now the value of ln 2 is 0.693. Okay. Now lambda t half is equal to ln 2. T half is equal to 0.693 by lambda. So this is the formula of t half. We can calculate t half when we know the constant lambda. That is radioactive constant. Now the graph here, P is decreasing exponentially. Exponentially P is decreasing and exponentially D is increasing. And the point of intersection is the T half, that is half life. This is, look by example here, P naught, the original concentration of parent nuclei when the time is equal to 0. Now after 1 half life it will reduce to half P naught by 2. This is the concentration of parent nuclei after at present, and this is the second half life, and after second half life the concentration of radionuclei is reduced to P naught by 4, and this is the concentration of parent nuclei at present. And likewise, this is another half life, third half life, and now the concentration of parent nuclei reduced to P naught by 8, and this is another half life, now concentration is reduced to P naught by 16. Now after nth T half, now after the nth half life it will reduce to P naught divided by 2 to the power n. Now we can reduce the formula from here, P is equal to P naught divided by 2 to the power n. Now here n is the number of T half. Now look the example here, P naught, this is the concentration. Now if daughter nuclei concentration is R, so we have to calculate T half. So how can we calculate? Look, P naught is equal to P plus D. I have derived this in my previous lecture. So P naught minus P is equal to D. Okay, now P naught is equal to P is equal to P naught by 2 to the power n in my previous slide. P naught divided by 2 to the power n plus T. Now D is equal to P naught minus P naught divided by 2 to the power n. So if a daughter nuclear concentration is asked, we can calculate from this formula. Okay, this is the important formula. Now mean life or average life, mean life is equal to 1 by lambda, so t half is equal to 0.693 by lambda. Now lambda is equal to 0.693 by t half, so we can calculate average life or mean life. Okay, now number of half life, if number of half life is not given, we have to calculate by the formula. I am equal to total time span divided by time of one life. Total time span I have taken capital T, time of one half life T of T half. So if T is the 2000, that means total time span is 2000 and time of one half life is 200, then we can calculate easily and T divided by T of T half. So 2000 divided by 200, which will be equal to 10. So it will be equal to, answer will be 10. Okay. So in the next class, this is the end of the lecture here. In the next class, we will discuss the important numericals. I mean, minimum 20 numericals will be discussed in this series. Okay. So stay tuned with the channel and subscribe our channel. And now, thank you for your patience.